sixth graders, today in art, we will be making a landscape puzzle that shows the background, middle ground, and foreground. Take a look at this picture. The background is in the back. It's very far away and usually has the sky and the clouds and the sun. The middle ground is in the middle and it usually has the mountains in this picture. And the foreground is in the front. It looks like it's closest to us and has the people and the rocks. Now take a look at this next picture. Can you point to the background? If you pointed to the sky, you would be right. Now let's see if you can point to the middle ground. It has the striped grassy mountains. Now point to the foreground. The foreground's in the front and it has the people. Good job. Now that you know the ground lines, we can make our own landscape and then we're going to turn it into a puzzle. So follow along with me in this video and pause it when you need to catch up. All right, let's get started. For this picture, you're going to need some markers, crayons, a pencil. That's the basic stuff. If you want, you can use scissors to make it into a puzzle at the end. But if you don't have scissors, that's okay. I'm going to start off with my background. I have to make a background line. Maybe I'll do a curved line for a background. Now I need a midground. I'll just do a straight line for my midground. And for my foreground, maybe I'll do a wavy line. That was three different kinds of lines. Now I can add details. I think this part will be my sun. And maybe I'll add a tree. Maybe I'm at the beach and I'll do a palm tree. Notice how I'm overdrawing. I'm drawing over top of my lines. Because when I color on top of it, you won't be able to see it. Now I have to add some different types of lines. I think I'll do a curly line for my waves. I think I'll do some dotted lines for my beach sand. Maybe I'll do some zigzag lines on the hill. I can do all different kinds of lines here. This is up to you. And I think I'll do some straight lines on my trees. And some more straight lines for my sun. Some longer ones. There we go. All right, so that's the drawn part of your drawing. You can use markers if you have it to outline, or you can just use crayons, whatever you have to color in. All right, I'm going to outline my waves and all of my lines in different colors. Now that you have outlined everything in marker, you can use crayons to fill it in. Or you can keep going with the markers and coloring everything. right. That was the coloring part of your lesson. Now, if you want to make your landscape into a puzzle, you'll need scissors, but make sure that you're with a family member or an adult to help you use the scissors safely, okay? I'm gonna flip my drawing over, and to make it easy for me, I'm going to draw big lines of where I want to cut. So that was a big zigzag line, and now I'm gonna draw a big wavy line. That's gonna tell me where I should cut, okay? So I start off with my big zigzag line and cut slow to make it easier for you. Thumb on top, chop, chop, chop. Thumb on top, chop, chop, chop. All right, I cut out one side of my drawing. Now I can cut out the other side. I'm just following that line. Last one. And if you had little lines on the top for me, like I did because I took it out of my sketchbook, you can just cut that off. Now you can flip your puzzle back over and try to put it back together. Or ask somebody else to put it back together. I know those two because they have zigzags together. And this yellow goes with yellow, and orange goes with orange. Now you have a good landscape puzzle. I would put this in a bag so that you can keep it and it doesn't get all torn up later on. All right. Good job, first graders. Share your landscape puzzle with somebody in your family and see if they can put it together. Then try to tell them where your background is, your middle ground, and your foreground. I would love to see your artwork too, so post a picture to the discussion board below. All right, I'll see y'all later. Bye.